All right, what's going on, you South Chilean iguanas? I got a new video for you guys today. I'm going to be teaching you how to make some CRT visuals like the ones you see on the back. This is going to be all analog, so no effects or plugins needed. Let's get right into it. All right, so you're going to need some hardware here. First thing you're going to need is some RCA cables. So that's going to be the yellow, white, and red cables. These are going to plug into the TV. Then you're going to need an HDMI to AV upscaler. I grabbed this one from Amazon for like 15 bucks. This is what it looks like. Has an HDMI output as well. And of course, you're going to need some HDMI cables to plug into your laptop. I'm using a 2019 MacBook Pro, but you can run media from pretty much anything, a game console or media storage. And then also a HDMI to USB-C adapter if you need. And then of course, the main piece is a CRTV, so I have this Toshiba one that I picked up from Craigslist about 3 years ago. It's from the 90s. So here's the quick setup. Basically, you want your input device, so I'm using a MacBook for this, and then you plug in an HDMI cable into the HDMI to AV upscaler, and then plug the RCA cables directly into the TV. And this is kind of what my setup looks like. Excuse all of the cords. I was running a lot of different experiments, but like I said, you can even plug this into game consoles, which is really cool. And then here is gonna be the setup for the camera. You wanna get it as close as possible and parallel to the TV to get the best results. Make sure to turn off all the lights. You wanna do this in pitch black, but a negative fill will work in a pinch. So go ahead and start running your media and recording. Here's some common issues and some fixes I have. So you'll get this weird flickering from time to time. All you need to do is just readjust your shutter speed. I like 1/30. Then you can also get this weird warping or like color banding. And to fix that, just make sure you position your camera parallel to the screen and it's pitch black. And then lastly, if you're using text, make sure you scale it up to be as large as possible because it can become unreadable. Cool, circuit bending. So this is how you get all of these cool effects on the footage, and it actually requires a piece of analog hardware. So this is what my circuit bender looks like. I bought it about 3 years ago on Etsy, but I did some research and these are some that are available now. The cool thing about all of these is that they're handmade. So all of them are going to produce different effects depending on which one you buy, which is cool because you can make unique visuals. So here's how you wire everything up. It's pretty much the exact same as the diagram before, except you're introducing the frequency mixer. So you're going to take the RCA cables from the HDMI to AV upscaler. You're going to plug the video cord into the input of the frequency mixer, and then take another set of RCA cables or just a video cable and plug it into the out of the frequency mixer. And then take that output and put it in directly to the CRTV. And yeah, this is kind of what it looks like. So start feeding in some footage, and the fun part starts here. So play around with the knobs and dials and switches until you get a look that you like. Make sure you're recording throughout this process. Of course, yours is going to be plugged in, but I just had mine on my table so I can show you what it looks like. All right, once you've got your recorded footage, go ahead and drag it into a new composition in After Effects. I'm working in a 4K composition, so 3840 by 2160. I'm gonna go over to Effects here, type corner pin, and we're gonna drag this onto the footage. And essentially what this is gonna do is it's gonna allow us to skew the footage so that it fits the screen. Tweak it a little bit here. All right, so now that it's filling the entire screen, we want to get rid of some of this stuff over here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over to effects once again, and we're going to type Lumetri color. And this is going to allow us to adjust the color of everything. So I'm going to go into basic corrections, and then I'm going to drag the shadows all the way down to crush the blacks. And then I'm going to raise the highlights a little bit so it pops. That's looking pretty good to me.
And then usually what I'll do is I'll go ahead and add a sharpen effect on top. So we'll drag that onto the footage here. And then I'll increase the amount to about 10, anywhere between 10 and 15 looks good to me. And then from there, you can experiment with adding other effects on top. So one of my go-to effects is deep glow. So I'm going to drag that onto the footage. It's a bit intense right now, so I'm going to turn that down. I'm going to let that render out so you can see what that looks like. Cool, so like this. And from here, you can pretty much add whatever you want. So I think this look is done for me, but if I really wanted to mess with the look here, I can add some sort of distortion effect. So like turbulent displace, for example. And that'll completely change what the footage looks like as well.
All right, that's pretty much it for the tutorial, guys. If this has helped you out, please leave a like and comment down below if you have any extra questions. Feel free to DM me what you guys make using this. I'm always curious to see what you guys are making. Otherwise, yeah, have a great rest of your week, and I'll see you in the next one.